Cooking in the Kitchen at Olam's with registered dietitian Molly Morgan, Olam's cooking consultant.
Today, Molly's teaching us how to make a strawberry and chocolate chia pudding.
And these strawberries look perfect for this.
They look so good.
So I'm just slicing up a couple of fresh strawberries because they're going to go on top of our chia pudding. And we are going to get started right here in this mixing bowl.
Okay.
And of course we said chocolate, right?
Need chocolate.
Cocoa powder, unsweetened cocoa powder, 1/4 cup. And then we're going to use maple syrup as our sweetener.
Mm.
And that's 1/4 cup of pure maple syrup. You could use agave nectar or honey.
Okay.
Other sugars would work as well. And then we will add in our chia seeds.
How much is this?
It's 1/2 cup of chia seeds.
Okay.
And these tiny little guys are what makes this pudding all come together. And we've got 1/2 teaspoon of vanilla. And then I picked coconut milk, and I brought the package so people, if they're not familiar with how you can buy coconut milk, you can buy it just like you would find a 1/2 gallon of milk.
Okay.
And buy unsweetened, because obviously we've sweetened it up ourselves.
Pour some of this in.
Yes, so it's 1½ cups of the coconut milk. You could also use almond milk if you prefer that, or regular milk even.
Okay.
So this whisks together. And now it's really hard to believe. In fact, I'm going to leave this one right here on the counter so we can show everybody the difference.
Yes, I can't wait to see.
These tiny little seeds soak up 10 times their weight in water and are loaded with fiber and healthy fats. So that's what makes this pudding so great for us. And it actually looks like pudding. I'll show
you. Great snack, great dessert.
Great snack or dessert.
Wow. Oh my gosh, it's thick.
So in just about 1 to 2 hours, it'll set up and look just like a pudding. And we've got some spoons here. Yeah, give it a little stir.
Alrighty.
Isn't that cool?
That's crazy.
Now, if it got too thick on you, you could add a little bit more coconut milk just to, I hate to say water it down, but
thin
it out a little. Yeah.
Looks really good.
And then you transfer it over to serving dishes. So
okay.
I picked these kind of tall parfait dishes.
I can hold it for you if you want.
Sure. Carefully spoon it on in.
It might be kind of messy.
We'll leave some room at the top because we've got those delicious strawberries to add. And this technically makes 4 portions, but you could go ahead and have a little extra. The fiber in those seeds will help fill you up. We'll add our brightly colored strawberries.
Oh, they look so good.
Gotta get that one some strawberries too.
Of course.
Here we go.
Well, this looks delicious. Thank you so much, Molly. Cheers.
Cheers. For this strawberry chocolate chia pudding recipe, visit olams.com. Enjoy the day.
Cooking in the Kitchen was brought to you from the fully operational Thermidor Kitchen at Olam's.